in this situation, you always would feel that you could do more. You know, you could have done more. I don't know. You know, it's just everything happens so fast.
Visibly tired and distraught, limo driver Orville Brown tries to explain the tragic circumstances behind the fire that killed five of his passengers Saturday night. He had a total of 9 women in the vehicle, including 31-year-old Nariza Fojas. She was to travel to her native Philippines next month to be married. And the group, all nurses, had come together for a bachelorette party.
One of the ladies knocked on the partition and she said, "Smoke," and I figured that she was asking if she could smoke a cigarette.
But then Brown begins to smell the smoke and hears a frantic call from the women. He stops his car in the middle of the San Mateo-Hayward Bridge.
As soon as I pulled over, one of the ladies hops through the partition. I unlock the doors. I open the door. The lady hops through the partition. And at that time, there's 2 cars, one in front of us, I believe, one in back of us, and these guys are trying to help.
Within seconds, he says the entire car had burst into flames. Brown can only guess what had caused the fire.
I'm really not sure. I know it wasn't gas-related, and the car didn't blow up. It just engulfed in flames. I smelled carpet. I smelled wiring. I smelled plastic. I mean, to me, in my opinion, it probably was electrical.
Investigators say it will take several days to determine the cause. Meanwhile, the county coroner said this about the victims who were unable to get out.
One could say that they were getting away from the fire and that's why they were in the front towards the partition. And you could also probably say that they were trying to get out as well.
Brown says he doesn't know what he could have done differently. He had this message to the victims' families.
I'm sorry personally, and my heart goes out to you. I feel for you. I wish there was something that I could tell you because I know you guys are grieving as well as I am.
Now, Brown had only been a limousine driver for 2 months, but prior to that, he says he drove commercial vehicles and also airport shuttle buses. We should also point out that this particular limousine was authorized to carry 8 or fewer passengers. Of course, we now know that it had 9, but authorities haven't said whether or not it plays any significance into their investigation. Dan Simon, CNN, San Mateo, California.